I'm Chris Fox. I'm an associate scientist at AstraZeneca MedImmune, and my focus is on safety and efficacy testing for preclinical and clinical trials. Although there aren't a whole host of well-known LGBT role models in biotech, I've been lucky in that everywhere I've worked, there's been at least one out openly gay member of staff. And that's really made me feel comfortable to be myself at work.
My name is Michael Rivera, and I'm a biological anthropologist. Biological anthropology is the study of humans from a biological perspective. So we try to answer questions about how did we evolve and why do we see the diversity in humankind today. Growing up, I didn't really have many role models to look up to, but I've been told very recently by several undergraduates at Cambridge that I have served as a role model to them in being out and proud about who I am.
My name's Anna Langley. I work at University Information Services here at the University of Cambridge, and I'm a computer officer. Very early on, I got interested in the music by Wendy Carlos, who was a pioneer of electronic music in the late 60s and early 70s. She came out as trans a little bit later, though I didn't know it, of course, when I first heard her music. The interest in music I've kept ever since, and I still pursue that in my spare time. But it also got me interested in electronics and in particularly in computing as music went digital.
My name is Sarah Elgibali. I'm a scientist. I'm in EMBL EBI, Bioinformatics Institute, and I work in protein sequence analysis. I am officially a scientific database curator. Regarding role models, LGBT role models in science, sadly, there are very, very few of them. But it's not because we are not here. It's just we're not seen. We're not officially here.
My name is Elizabeth Nguyen. I work for the Sanger Institute, and I'm a researcher on developmental disorders. I think I've been quite lucky in terms of my career and my sexuality in that I've never felt that I had to make a specific choice because of my sexuality. I've lived and worked in very liberal cities in the UK, so that has never really been an issue for me.
I'm quite lucky in that being LGBT hasn't had an impact on my career. And I think that has to do with the fact that everywhere I've worked, there's been other openly gay members of staff.
Being LGBT in science has been really tough. It affected me in many ways. Like, for starters, I had to come out of academia. It's just the environment didn't work out and made it really, really hard to come out as well. But it also prompted me to make the decision that I need to work with what I love, somewhere where I can be accepted, somewhere more progressive, more inclusive, and maybe more international.
Being trans has affected my career. It started in high school when I was affected emotionally by it, with depression, and it affected my grades, which went down. So I couldn't go to university straight after I finished high school. I did a succession of jobs. Then when I came out in my late 20s, everything, my career stopped, and I had to reevaluate. And I then went to university and read computer science and mathematics. Then worked in other jobs. Sometimes that was awkward because of my being trans, so I've had to stop and start a few times. But now I'm working here and things have been going fairly well.
When I was younger, my mother used to tell me a very important lesson in life. She taught me that one of the most important things was that I put a lot of work into studying, and as long as I was happy and healthy, there's nothing wrong with being gay or being who I want to be. So she always taught me to value oneself and not worry about what other people think.
So I think the Sanger is a good place to work in general. They do a lot of things here for on campus to support people's work-life balance in general.
Working in IT, it's still very much a straight white male cis environment. But generally, I think that the university is really trying to do the right thing in terms of diversity. It's trying to ensure that people are treated fairly, regardless of their background, their gender identity, their sexuality.
I think it's really important to have a strong community around you when you do science and when you do academia, because you really do need some people to be supportive of you. I've always found it very easy to be open and honest about who I am in front of other people, with other people in Cambridge. So I do feel quite well supported and happy.
Working at AstraZeneca MedImmune, it's a really supportive environment. We've got an employee resource group called AZ Plus, and the plus stands for people like us. I don't think I would be as confident as I am at work if I didn't have people around me who were openly gay or openly lesbian, people who were happy to be themselves. It made me feel that I could be myself.
If you're not visible as someone who's LGBT, intersexual, queer, non-binary, whatever, then you're making it that little bit harder for other people to be open about their experience too. And you make it that little bit harder for them to be who they are, for them to be comfortable in their own skin in the working environment.
I think it's important to be who you are, to be able to live as your authentic self, because you're never going to be truly happy or productive or complete if you're trying to silence or hide some part of yourself.
We need people not to discriminate against us. We need people to be able to hire us and not have a negative outlook on us or think that our performance is in any way less than any person. That's why we need to do this. We need to say, no, I am a person. I work 150% and I am LGBT.
Cambridge has been really great. There's a real emphasis on it's what you can bring to the table in STEM rather than who you are. It's about what you can achieve, not what your sexuality is.
I think Cambridge is a great place for people to work, especially LGBT scientists. It's a really supportive place, and you know, just very liberal. I don't think that, you know, there's a lot of discrimination or anything. And it's just a fun place to live.
With such a diverse, knowledgeable population in Cambridge, I think it's very likely that you will find many friends to make here with common interests to you. You will find lots of allies who are open to different backgrounds and different sexualities, and maybe you'll even find someone very special to spend time with.
Being in Cambridge has helped me come out. And not just to my friends and family, but also to work. And it's the first time in my long career where I can officially say, yeah, here I am, and and I'm not the only one. So Cambridge has been very, very good to me.